I was born here. I lived my entire adult life right here in Arizona. These people are the fiber of what our state is all about, and we welcome them.
It's not to be taken for granted.
No. You and I both lead very privileged lives, mm-hmm. and it could change like that.
But we wouldn't have had that opportunity if our ancestors weren't welcome to this country.
Exactly.
And given all the opportunities that they were given.
I made a special effort to go down to El Salvador, Guatemala, Honduras, mm-hmm. that way down, to really see the violence and what these people are fleeing. Is not only real, it's devastating. They're fleeing for their lives.
Right, and certainly not your husband, but there are other politicians who use fear-mongering to, yeah. A, get elected and tell you you need to be afraid of these people. Mm-hmm. Voters need to really pay attention to that and see if you think these people are to be afraid of.
I know.
And they're not, they're like your family. We all want a roof over our heads, mm-hmm. for our families, our, mm-hmm. kids, food in everybody's mouth, some good medical care, mm-hmm. and a good education, mm-hmm. and opportunity. And I don't think you're going to go anywhere in the world where somebody doesn't want that.
You know, I ultimately believe in the good nature of human beings.
I do too.
That's my bottom line. So every time I get frustrated or feel like, you know, why do we even do this? I'm getting nowhere. You know, I realize if we don't, then who will?